From the study done by Uganda National Teachers Union and Education International on the rapid assessment of privatization and commercialization of education in Kampala metropolitan area, private schools and education institutions outnumber public early child education, primary and secondary schools.
But the challenges of UPE and USE schools have been exploited by some investors to establish private education institutions, in most cases within close proximity to the public schools, with the intention of making profits from those that cannot gain admission in public schools.
To make matters worse, the study indicates that private participation in education is motivated by financial gains, not about extending education as a service to the people.
Some private schools are very expensive, and what is marketed as quality education is in most cases as a result of intensive coaching of students, learners to pass the national examinations.
Speaking at the launch of the campaign to stop privatization and commercialization of education, Philbert Baguma, the General Secretary of UNATU, expressed concern that education is gradually becoming for the privileged few. He noted that parents are struggling to take back their children to school because of high tuition fees and unrealistic requirements.
The schools were almost empty, and the parents were running up and down. Those who had raised the school fees could not raise the money for requirements.
UNATU says rapid commercialization of education is promoting intensive coaching instead of quality education and compromising teacher qualification by hiring less qualified teachers who will accept low salaries, therefore undermining the national education standards.
On issues of teacher qualification, most of the private schools hire less qualified teachers and pay low salaries as a way of minimizing costs.
UNATU believes stopping commercialization of education can only be achieved by revamping public schools, building more public schools, improving funding to public schools, stepping up compliance to minimum standards, and rolling out robust monitoring regulatory framework.
A school where every child is taught by a highly trained, professionally qualified teacher, a teacher who has the necessary support, decent salaries and working conditions.
While launching the campaign, the commissioner in charge of basic and secondary education, Ismail Mulindwa, who represented the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Education, admitted that over-liberalization of education was a regrettable mistake because schools went into hands of business people.
We may not stop private schools, because to be sincere to you, government may not have the capacity at the moment to provide education every Ugandan in all parts of the country. We may still need some private schools.
Government committed on behalf of the Ministry of Education to address gaps in universal primary education to improve quality of education offered in public schools.
To take this campaign forward on increasing funding for public education.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.